Benvenuti alla Casa Italiana Zerilli-Marimò della New York University. As you know, this event is organized by the American Italian Cultural Roundtable, and we are delighted to partner up with them in bringing the Long Island Mandolin and Guitar Orchestra here at Casa Italiana. Probably there is no instrument that is more associated to Italian Americans than mandolin, and very often it's used in a derogatory way, but we love this instrument, we love the sound of it, and we love the things that you can do with it. And therefore, we are very grateful to the Roundtable for bringing this beautiful group of musicians here to play for us. As you know, this is also the last event of the season for the American Italian Cultural Roundtable. Therefore, it's also my chance to wish you a very happy Christmas and a wonderful new year, and to give you an arrivederci to the coming year in 2016. I think this is also the first event that you have here after the passing of our founder, Baroness Zerilli-Marimò. You still see that our flags are in mourning for that. And I just wanted to tell you that it was very much within the mission of the Casa that she conceived, that the Casa would be open to Italians and Italian Americans, and to present the experiences of the Italian Americans as a larger part of the Italian experience in this country. So, and I thank all of you, the members of the American Italian Cultural Roundtable that participated in our loss with your participation to the service in tribute to the mass. So thank you for that. And without further ado, I would like to invite the chairman of the American Italian Cultural Roundtable, Cavaliere Aldo Marcusi. Thank you. Commendatore, he got a promotion and I'm still using the lower term. Unforgivable. Commendatore, mi scuso.
Never. Anyway, I'm so proud of this new title that I would not let him get away with that. I was Cavaliere Ufficiale for 17 years, and this past June they bestowed the Commendatore. It's a very important title in the Italian community. In fact, it has opened doors for the Enrico Caruso Museum, for which I am also the founder and curator. This evening, we're so happy to have all of you here today. I have to first congratulate Peter Riso. I don't see him here today yet, but I think he's stuck on a train somewhere. And so I have to say this about Peter. He's helped us put this program together, and was also celebrating the life of his sister Rose Riso, who was a, certainly we want to say, one of the award winners of 9/11. She actually was a hero because she stood behind and chased all of the women and men who worked in our war, because she was a fire marshal. And she worked at her trade, actually worked in getting all the people out. And all her friends that moved from that office later on made a statement and said, when I wanted to call my father to tell him I was coming home, she said, hang up and leave this building immediately. You'll call when you're outside. She stood behind, and of course, she passed away there. So she's a hero of 9/11, and we thank Peter for keeping her memory alive. It's on your program. If you see it there, you'll see why we honor Peter, and of course, his sister Rose Riso. Okay, so we did that, and we want to thank, of course, all of you for coming in tonight with this rain and all. There's a lot of people that I think are still trying to get here. But in any event, thank you so much for showing up. I'd like to introduce to you a young man who I was thrilled to have at the museum. We had a bunch of students from Juilliard, you know, and a lot of them were enthusiastic about Caruso and the music that I played for them on some very old machines. But this one gentleman who's with us this evening, he's very enthusiastic about the instrument that he plays, the Zampogna, which is an old Sicilian and Neapont or Campania area, and the two Sicilies, you might say, very popular instrument. Well, he said to me, Aldo, I have an instrument like this in my car. Would you like to hear it? I said, certainly. So he went down, got this instrument, and played it for us. Everybody went nuts. So I said to him, would you like to come to this evening's performance? He says, yes. So I'm going to call him up. David is going to come up and play his Zampogna for us. And he's going to play the Tarantella. But just let me pre-warn you, we don't allow any dancing here. So no Tarantellas.
Why not?
No Tarantellas, but we're going to hear this very enthusiastic young man who has his heritage come from both Sicily and the Campania area. So he has a lot going for himself, and he's always going back, and he's a student of NYU, and going for his master's. So we're so happy to have him here. And if anytime you want to start, David, okay. And this is like he's going to talk a little bit about his instrument.
Yeah. Should I stand up here?
Sure.
I'm trying not to fall off my plane. So this, thank you for the introduction, and this is the Zampogna. And it's one of several different types of bagpipes found in southern Italy. And as you just heard, I have family from the Campania region, and this pipe is from the town of San Gregorio Magno, which is in southern Campania, right above Basilicata. And that's the town that my grandfather's family is from. That's where I got this instrument a few years ago. So I'm gonna start out, I'm gonna play a little bit of a pastorale, which is a type of song that invokes the countryside. And then I'm going to go into a tarantella just to make sure everyone's awake before the performance. But
thank you.
I'll go ahead.
Thank you.
My name is John Caparelli, and I'm a member of the
American Italian Roundtable, and Aldo asked me to introduce the orchestra. But first, I want to tell you a little story. Aldo does everything for the organization, and one of the things he does is he orders the cookies, focaccia, makes the coffee. So he calls me one day and he says, "John, I want to bring a zambonia to the casa. What do you think?" So I'm saying, "It must be some kind of a pastry you make over the it's a good idea." But it was much sweeter. This is much sweeter. So anyways, my job is to introduce the orchestra, but I'm not going to do that because all the information you need is in here. I'm just going to say this is Lucille, who's the kind of organizing the group. But what I'd like to do is ask each, and since it says that you people are from varied backgrounds, could you introduce yourself and say where you come, like what you do to make a living?
Our day job. First of all, let me just say we are not the entire Long Island Mandolin Guitar Orchestra. We're just a sort of representative sample that fits on your stage. But anyway, my name is Lucille DiBello Bjørneby. I married a Norwegian, sorry. And in my real life, I'm a retired attorney.
I'm Bill Sloven. I'm in technology, living out on Long Island.
I'm Sue Weber. I'm a retired orchestra teacher.
I'm Vicki Gleischer, and I'm a retired elementary school teacher.
Except for the name, I'm Roz Curis, and I'm also a retired elementary school teacher.
I'm Craig Lea. I'm a manager in construction projects.
How many members of the whole orchestra?
We have about 25 now. 25. Yep.
Where can we hear you perform as an ensemble, the whole orchestra?
Well, we perform every year at the Hofstra Italian Festival. And lately we've also been performing at the Smithtown Italian Festival, which usually takes place in June. And then at various times of the year, we perform in libraries. We performed in the Syosset Library recently. We perform at assisted living facilities and nursing homes. We're going to be performing at a gated community in Syosset next week. So we're all around. We're building a new website.
Good.
Which will let you know where our gigs are and how to find us.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you.
So without further ado,
thank you. That was a 1955 song, Come Prima. But for our next song, we're going to go much farther back in time, back to 1880. And for this song, we are going to hear from someone who's been a wonderful friend to the Long Island Mandolin and Guitar Orchestra, a professional tenor named Jonathan Goodman, who, despite the ethnic disadvantage of being a Scotsman, is a wonderful interpreter of Italian songs. Jonathan has sung all over the world in all kinds of venues, and he teaches voice at Adelphi University and at Nassau Community College. So Jonathan and I are going to sing, well, we'll see if you recognize it.
Thank you.
language in the world. So I would now like to sing for you the popular Christmas song, Astro del Ciel, also known as Silent Night.
Sing along too.
That's right. If you know the words, you can correct me if I get them talking about.
Thank you.
Italian Christmas song, written by a saint in 1732.
They already said.
Oh. Yes. Okay, well, it was written by a saint, and it's a real Italian Christmas carol, not one translated. So, Crescendi,
you can sing along.
You can sing along to anything.
That's true, if you know the words. All right, wait, let me turn to the right.
Thank you.
Ernesto de Curtis wrote the song that Jonathan is going to sing for us now, one of the most beautiful songs I ever heard, Non ti scordare. I shouldn't even bother announcing the whole knower.
Tell her, tell that lady friend of yours what I think of her, right?
In a good way. It's in a good way.
Yeah. You'll see.
And I'm going to be accompanied by my friend Carlo Treglia.
Thank you.
song written by Giovanni Capurro. Well, the lyrics were written by Giovanni Capurro, but the music was composed by Eduardo Di Capua. And the name of it is O Sole Mio. I thought somebody was going to jump in. No, O Sole Mio.
Oh, Should I sing or just play it?
and Jonathan's going to sing it now.
Okay.
Thank you.
But for our finale, we thought it was appropriate to dedicate the song to the country that's given the Italians and so many other people around the world the opportunity to grow and prosper in freedom, the United States of America. Okay. And that was the patriotic finale.
From Williamsburg, so you've got a well-deserved
Thank you all again for showing up. Thank you.